Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nature, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. I make t-shirts and I put it on, and that's putting light on lampstand. We are living lampstands. And if somebody is interested, he will knock on my shoulder and ask me question. Then I can tell him. You don't throw pearls before swines. That means people who are not interested, you don't keep on talking, you know, for nothing. So you have to find customer for your pearls. His word is pearls. So we should not throw it before swines. So people who are interested are long for his word. They only should ask you question and engage you in a lively discussion. So I have about 10-12 designs which I put on my website, and I've made in making a new one, which is I made a rough sketch, and it is a bit difficult for me to make a proper drawing or proper presentation. Maybe you have the skill, you know, in IT and can help me. I explain this one, and then I will put a link. I will put this one on my website and give a link to you that you can then understand what I say, and may help me to produce a drawing that is suitable for t-shirt printing. So here is the gist of the presentation. On the top of the t-shirt, I always put ask arrows. It represent once born people. When you are twice born, you become a seeker, seek, agape, and then knock, philo. Philo is the love, philosophical love. So seek are the twice born laborers. The vineyard of our father. People of four varnas. Varnas are in Punjab, in India, varna is well known. They are called professions. They have nothing to do with tribes. The Satan of India have translated varna into tribes. They call it a jati, which is absolutely nonsense, wrong, you know. So these people of India, they are emperors and kings of darkness. Princes of Middle East, they are just princes, as explained earlier. So this is there is a vineyard, and it has a gate, narrow gate for solitary people. And there's a kiln of his word. You must pass through this kiln to enter this one. If you don't like his word, you can't enter into this vineyard. Or if you love mammon, you can't enter. Judas Iscariot was thrown out. Only the people who loved God, they were welcomed into the vineyard of our father, which is the royal kingdom of God, where Jesus washed their feet to welcome them. Judas Iscariot was out. His feet was not washed. So, in this vineyard, these candles are the once born, unlit, no light, and the other one are twice born. These are four varnas: Shudra, Vaish, Kshatri, and Brahman. These are twice born, you know. Only the once born is the people of Shudra Varna. Peter was the example. The other doubting Thomas, and then John, the John, Matthew, etc., sealed to serve God, and then you have this rabbi and those who preach ideal rabbi like John the Baptist. So they all seek the word from Christ. So Christ is sitting here, as shown, not a good picture. So this is a Jesus, the true vine that is planted by our Father God in his vineyard. And Jesus then went in out into the world and hired laborers, and they were 11. Judas Iscariot got himself elected, that he has the skill, you know, all that. But Jesus knew the matters of his heart right up to the end. So this is the true vine. He's planted in the vineyard of our Father, and Jesus used to take his sheep, this is the fold also, used to take his sheep out to graze, that means to preach gospel and bring them to rest in the Father's house. When you are in Christ, you have nothing to worry, because then Christ looks after your affairs. So this is a Christ Jesus planted by our Father. So in Jesus we are royal priests, called laborers, not disciples. Only righteous people can become the laborers. If you are not righteous, you are racist, you are doing wrong things, doing favors to people, you can't enter into this vineyard. Then our anointed royal high priest, Christ Jesus. So these are the this is the fruit wine producing grapes that lead to new wine. And our aim is to get ourselves grafted to this true vine. So when you get grafted, then the root is Christ Jesus. So we owe to Christ Jesus a lot. That is why we honor Christ Jesus for giving us the food, so that we can then eat it, and then we can preach gospel. The food is the flesh of Jesus. And when we preach gospel, we are drinking the blood of Christ. That means we are representing our anointed elder brother, Christ Jesus. Christ Jesus planted by our Father means he, whatever comes out of his mouth, man shall not live by bread alone, but what comes out of the mouth of God. So is the mouth of God, you know, mouthpiece of God, spokesman of God. So apostles grafted to our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus. So these are twice born, you know, as I've shown. This is the killing, his word. So this is this for solitary seeker. No two person can enter through this gate. That is why you can't pour Eucharist wine from one cup into the other, because each person receives gospel from our Father on individual basis. Remember, Christ Jesus could not give gospel to Peter. Only once he gave the glimpse, when Peter said, "You are the living Christ or living God," then Jesus stressed, "Unless our Father give, you can't have it." So here is gatekeeper, no liars. allowed. Gatekeeper is Peter. He is the gatekeeper. He killed two liars, you know, Ananias and Sapphira. So no liars are allowed into the church of God. But today the priests are liars, and so are their disciples. Disciple means those who follow you blindly. The Jesus had no disciple. Hirelings, dog-collar robed priests, or fathers they call them in some churches, cannot find this narrow gate because they are blind themselves. They can't find this narrow gate, and they just follow the wide gate and all that leads to sectarian riots. Peter killed liars. You must speak truth. An Antichrist have a following of blind disciples. Only blind disciple, you know, they go to these Antichrist as they go into the monasteries. Another thing, the abbot, he will clip their hair, and after clipping their hair, then they are told to do what the abbots tell you to do. Sometime I go to this monastery and I try to give them my article which I have written. The people will take it and then they give it back to me. Oh no, no, we are not allowed to take any literature from anybody else. Only our abbots gives us the literature, what we need to do. He gives us the instruction, we follow him, as blind people follow the others. So they are engaged in prayers as if our Father is dumb and deaf, like Yahweh. Yahweh used to be dumb and deaf. He is demiurge. He is not real. Our Father is real. So that's how they keep the people busy and enslave them. So the slavery had become worse, as stated by Christ Jesus in Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, the arid temple priest, which was sacked, arid evil spirit. They were evil spirited. They could not find green pasture because we have been made solitary royal priest. So they said, oh, let's go back to the church of God. They entered the church of God. They took the poison Torah with them, and they killed the spirit of the people. And only those who were blind to spirit, they rushed into such churches. Whereas those who were not blind, they hated those churches. And that's why these apostles, when they were hated, they gave open air discourses. Some were handmade towers, and they will sit on top of the tower and speak to everyone. Open air, like they do it in Hyde Park Corner in London. So they were giving this one because in Jesus, you cannot make a following. In Jesus, everyone has to give his own account to God. If I make a following, I can't give your account to God, and I become an antichrist. So people like Billy Graham and all these people, when they give lectures, or they call it, the whole football fields are filled with the blind followers. So Billy Graham does not give them any, make them solitary, because he himself is not solitary. He himself is a disciple. Disciple means a one small person that needs disciplining. We are not disciple in Christ Jesus. We are sensible people and we are laborers employed by Christ Jesus in the vineyard of our Father. Unless your name is written in the book of our Father, you cannot enter into that vineyard. So try to get yourself awaken yourself spiritually and become a laborer of Christ Jesus and enter into his vineyard and emulate yourself to get grafted to the true vine planted by our Father Christ Jesus. So when we preach gospel, we preach gospel in honor of Christ Jesus, because he is the true vine to which we are grafted. And if we are not grafted to that one, we will wither away. So that is why, you know, we honor Christ Jesus. All the apostles then honored, as they spoke, as they became the spokesman of Christ Jesus. So I am too a spokesman of Christ Jesus, because I have grafted myself to the true vine, and hope more people will graft themselves and become spokesmen of our Father to honor Christ Jesus and to glorify our Father. Honor means that we honor a person for his knowledge we get. His word was spoken by Jesus. So we eat the flesh of Jesus. That is our life-giving bread. That's what Peter said, you have the bread of life. So we eat the bread of life. And when we preach gospel, after we have digested that bread in our heart, not in the stomach, this is the mouth, you eat it, goes into your heart, out comes from your mouth, not from the back passage as the other one. And when it comes out of the mouth, that is the blood of Christ we are drinking. So unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you are no part in Christ Jesus, because you are not representing him. So to represent him, you must open your mouth. Many people are frightened to preach gospel, but you need to build up confidence. Remember that a Jew is one who is inwardly and not outwardly. When these people become Jews inwardly, outwardly, they break their covenant with Abraham, because Abraham was not a Jew, he was a Semite. So when they become unfaithful to Abraham, they become tares. Parable of wheat and tares, Matthew 13, verse 24 to 30. And that is why they are bundled up in Israel now. And more bundling up takes place in a couple of years. And that is why there is trouble in the Middle East. Syria and all those countries will be flattened. So don't worry, because this is the will of our Father. Anybody who forgets his tribal father, every plant which my heavenly Father did not plant, heavenly Father is Yahweh, which did not plant, will be pulled up by the roots, will be killed. So these people are seeking the help of becoming a Muslim, Christian or Jew, or Sikh or Hindu, of physical bodies. They are swearing their covenant with their tribal fathers. They are not the plant planted by Heavenly Father, so they will die, they will be killed in sectarian riots. So you will see how these sectarian riots will dwell in Egypt and in other countries. Our Father God blesses you, and if you can help, then please let me know. I need help in IT and also in establishing a t-shirt printing business. so that I can promote gospel.